music in me. I got the music in me.
I got the music in me.
I got the music in me. I got the music in me.
Ladies and gentlemen, Marti Caine.
And good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the show. Actually, a show with a difference this evening because we have no guests at all. Here's a quick flash. And no guests except, of course, for Arthur Greenslade and the audience and the Jeff Richard dancers. And it gives me a chance to sort of, well, sing some of the songs that you've requested and also some of my particular favourites, beginning with one that was my last single. And as my producer said, thank goodness it was your last. And it's called I've Never Been to Me.
Hey, lady, you lady, cursing at your life. You're a discontented mother. A regimented wife. I've no doubt you dream about things you'll never do. But I wish someone would talk to me like I'm gonna talk to you. I've been to Georgia, California, and anywhere I could run. And I took the hand of the preacher man. Friendly faces, 'cause I have this need to be free. I've been to paradise, but I've never been to me. Hey, lady, you lady, please don't walk away. You see, I have this need to tell you.
why I'm all alone today. And I can see so much of you still living in your eyes. Share a part of this weary heart that has lived a million lives. In Tunis, on the Isles of Greece, and I sip champagne on a yacht. I move like bottles from Monte Carlo, but I show them what I got. I've been undressed by kings, and I've seen some things that a woman ain't supposed to see. I've been to paradise, but I've never been to me. Sometimes I've been to cry for unborn children that might have made me complete. I'm gonna took the sweet life and never knew I'd be bitter from the sweet. I've spent my life exploring, subtle whoring, but it costs too much to be free. I've been to paradise, but I've thank you very much. This next song is a very unusual song in as much as it's a true story about a lion who became very, very famous because of some of his adventures. Do you want to hear about it? Step this way. Now, Fraser was an Asian lion living in a cage of iron in a circus out at Tijuana. Frasier was the big attraction, and he gave them satisfaction, doing it with talent and with honor. Growling for his daily dinner, Frasier kept on getting thinner with each measly can of Spam or tuna. Times were lean, but he was leaner. So one day in Pasadena, through the bars he split for South Laguna. Oh, cruel is fate, but it's never too late, said Frasier. I'm 91 and I haven't a son, thought Frasier. The blue-eyed truth is I'm ready for euthanasia. Oh, matted and tarry, a local safari rescued poor old Frasier. Yes, it did. First they combed his tangled tresses, housed him with the lionesses, fools, thinking him a harmless old grandpapa. Fed him niacin and thoride, B1, 2, 6, 12 and chloride, clams, cod liver oil, cobalt and copper, even ginseng. Younger studs brought in for breeding, wound up beaten, bruised and bleeding. Every dawn the same thing kept occurring. Stretched out on an old serape, there lie Frasier, tired but happy, all his ladies on the nest and purring. Oh, cruel is fate, but it's never too late, said Frasier. Announce the feast, I am the king of the beasts, said Frasier. But king or not, I am certainly hot, said Frasier. Hey, and when you're hot, boy, and in a spot, the action will amaze ya. True, true, true. Children by his wives 11 added up to 57. Such nocturnal bliss he must have tasted. For no matter what the right time, daytime, noontime, didn't make no difference. You found him fast asleep, just wasted. Woo! When the circus owner found him
brought a lawsuit to him pounding, claiming you cats got to go where we go. Crazy Lord, hasta la vista. You think all these girls are my sister? I'm in business for myself, amigo. Oh, cruel is fate, but it's never too late, called Frasier. I thank my stars I am not behind bars, thought Frasier. Hey, they pay to see what comes naturally in Asia. Oh, yeah, no African cat ever had it like that. You kept it up like Frasier. 11 widows, Frasier. He's up above, dear Frasier. With all its strategy, leaves me battling with my pride. But through the insecurity, some tenderness survives. Just another rider, still trapped within my truth. A hesitant prize fighter, still trapped within. Sometimes when we touch, the honesty's too much, and I have to close my eyes and cry. I wanna hold you till I die, till we both break down and cry. Wanna hold you till this fear in me subsides. I understand you, and I know how hard you try. I've watched while love commands you, and I've watched love pass you by. At times I think we're drifters, still searching for a friend, a brother or a sister, but then the passion flares again. Sometimes when we touch, the honesty's too much, and I have to close my eyes and cry. I wanna hold you till I die, till we both break down and cry. I wanna hold you till this fear in me He will dance the old world's soft shoe. He jumps so high, jumps so high, and then it lightly touched down. I met him in a cell in New Orleans. I was down and out. He looked to me to be the very eyes of age, as he spoke right out. He talked of life, talked and talked of life. Then he laughed and slapped his legs dead. He said his name, Bojangles. Then he danced a lick right across the sail. He grabbed his pants, took a better stance. Oh, how he jumped. Clicked his heels. He let go a laugh. He let go a laugh. Shook back his clothes all around. Mr. Bojangles, Mr. Bojangles, Mr. Bojangles. He said, I dance now at every chance and honky tonks, for drinks and tips. But most my time I spend behind these counter bars. Yeah. I guess I drinks a bit. He shook his head. And as he shook his head, I swear I heard someone ask, please, Mr. Bojangles, Mr. Bojangles, Mr. Bojangles. Can't seem to change. like a jaybird flying home to Montreal.
Flying home.
Sleeping in your coffee for a while. Seems like he backed into a square meet and is in for the night.
I must ask you something. Do you ever send away for daft things in the small ads? Do you? I do. I do it all that. And I can't be the only one. Come on, admit it. Who sends away for things out the small ads?
Yes.
Especially you, sir. I mean, that suit. I'm not being rude or anything, but you didn't buy that in a shop, did you? No, I knew you didn't. I recognised it the minute I saw it. Unrepeatable bulk purchase of young executive suits with self-adjusting sleeves and free whoopee cushion with every order. Money back if not delighted. Are you delighted, sir? Are you? Doesn't take much to please some, does it? No, don't worry, you know, I'm just as bad. Just a minute, I'll sit down. Excuse me. I wish I could do this elegantly, I really do. No, but I'm just as bad. I mean, I'm a sucker for the small ads. If it must be cleared, I'll buy it. I've got myself one of these K-pop lined ex-commando nightgowns at home. True. Just the thing for those cold nights when you're alone, and if you're not alone, you soon will be when you wear one of these. As a matter of fact, it's Exhibit A in my divorce case. It is. It's dreadful. And I send away for anything. I've got one of these ballpoint pens that'll write upside down at 50 fathoms. Very useful. Dear mother, well, here I am upside down at 50 fathoms, they're great. But my tear gas fountain pen, guaranteed to repel any attacker, went off in the Roxy during The Sound of Music, and it'll never quite be the same again. Apparently, in the dark, I'd mistaken it for me combined pencil slim all-purpose torch and switchblade cigarette lipstick lighter. Also guaranteed to repel any attacker. If there are any attackers to be repelled. No, I'm the one. I've got a better defence system than NATO. Although they only use my automatic pocket alarm system, money back if not delighted guaranteed, was when I was approached by a sinister figure on my way home. And he had one as well. I wouldn't have minded, but he got his out first. Yeah, and the anti-smoking tablets I sent for, they worked marvellously. They were fabulous, except for the side effects. The first morning, I got up early, put the cat in the washing machine, broke next door's windows and mugged the milkman. And I've got every petrol-saving device you can send for on my car. I have. And if only half of them work, the tank should overflow every 15 miles. And it don't. It don't. Of course, not everything I send for, you know, is a failure. For instance, I have a bar in the corner of, you know, of my lounge. It was from one of those, send for a bar to put in the corner of your lounge adverts and amuse and entertain your friends in style. It was such a success that I had to hang a no coaches sign on the front gate. It got spoilt in the end because my friends started bickering about why wasn't a serving fast enough and why didn't I open at 5 o'clock like the Jolly Butchers? And they formed one of these committees and turned my front room into a club, membership only. And they won't let me join. But the best thing I ever sent for, I wish I'd got my photos, you could have passed them round. The best thing I ever sent for was my Wren officer-style trench coat. Oh, I look fabulous in that. As smart as any officer who ever stepped into a trench. Great. You know, with the belt tied really tight and my borough council surplus bra. Oh, really special. Really, you know, brief encounter-ish. In a bad light, I look like Trevor Howard. Then I lost it last night at a rather hippie party. You see, I gave it to this young man to hold for me whilst, you know, I got to put my arms in it. And when I looked round, it'd gone. Well, apparently it was from a member of one of these music lovers societies. And they've taken my favourite Mac as a hostage. They have. This morning they sent me a note and one of the buttons off it. And if I don't stop singing, they're going to cut all the buttons off and break it down. But I'm going to be brave. We all read and hear everybody tells us that 17 or thereabouts is the best time of your life. But for some of us, it can be pretty desperate.
I learned the truth at 17, that love belongs to beauty queens and high school girls with clear skin smiles who marry early then retire. The Valentines I never knew, the Friday night charades of youth were spent on one more beautiful. At 17 I learned the truth. Desperately remained at home, inventing lovers on the phone, who called to say, come dance with me, and murmured vague obscenities. It isn't all it seems, at 17. They only get what they deserve. While the rich relationed hometown queen marries into what she needs with a guarantee of company and haven for the elderly. Girls like me.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, the Jeff Richard Dancers.
Last night I said goodbye. Now it seems years. I'm back in the city where nothing is clear but thoughts of me holding. Strong yearning air.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. That's just about it for this week. We hope you've enjoyed the slightly different show. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you next week. Thank you.
Considering so many folks dissatisfied with everything, who need someone to understand they're lonely, they're lonely, and they're not alone, and everywhere they shrug their shoulders, tell themselves that they don't care, and all the while believe they're happy, oh, they're happy, but not really. And they're asked to hold the world together, make it happen, give it to children. Criticize the world that I have grown up in. Most of you would tell me that I'm crazy. Yes, I'm crazy. I can't help it. I understand that where you are is where you've been so many years. Things that tend to change you, tend to hurt you. Yes, they hurt you very deeply. And we're asked to hold the world together, make it happen, give it to children. Turning on to